Here's another headline that came out of the awards ceremony. Oprah Winfrey for President of the United States. Seriously, the speculation was apparently triggered by Winfrey's address at the Golden Globes, chiefly her final lines.
So I want all the girls watching here and now to know that a new day is on the horizon. And when that new day finally dawns, it will be because of a lot of magnificent women, many of whom are right here in this room tonight, and some pretty phenomenal men fighting hard to make sure that they become the leaders who take us to the time when nobody ever has to say, me too, again.
Then came the report filed by CNN, and I'm quoting, Oprah Winfrey is actively thinking about running for president. Two of her close friends told CNN Monday the two friends who requested anonymity in order to speak freely talked in the wake of Winfrey's extraordinary speech at the Golden Globe Sunday night, which spurred chatter about a 2020 run. The point being made was that if Donald Trump, also a celebrity TV star with no experience of government, could become president of the US, why not Oprah Winfrey? The heartthrob of millions of Americans. The online Slate magazine, in a provocatively titled article, asked some common sense questions. It's safe to assume that Oprah will be in charge of the country in January 2021, if not sooner, but how will she govern? Who will be appointed to key roles in her administration? Might she, like Trump promised to do, overcome her lack of government experience and policy knowledge by selecting, quote-unquote, the best people to advise her? It then went on to list the dubious characters Ms. Winfrey has promoted on her television show. Dr. Oz, who advertised miracle pills and fat busters. Dr. Phil McGraw, who exploited drug addicts. Jenny McCarthy, who was against children being vaccinated against infectious diseases. Actress Suzanne Somers, who took 60 pills a day to fight aging. Donald Trump had a different take on it, though. He said, and I'm quoting again, people were worried about Obama coming to their homes and taking away their guns. Oprah will come to your homes and leave books there, which is far, far worse. This is a woman who, every chance she got, told people to join her book club. That's Donald Trump for you. For the record, though, America elected actor Ronald Reagan to the presidency. Terminator star Arnold Schwarzenegger was governor of California. Clearly, there's room for more. And frankly, if Donald Trump can win the presidency, why can't Oprah Winfrey? But does she have what it takes? We did a SWOT analysis for you, and this is what we found. Let's look at her strengths first. At 63, Oprah Winfrey is younger than some of the top Democrats who might run, including former Vice President Joe Biden and U.S. Senator Bernie Sanders. Just like Trump, Oprah's wealth could be an enormous asset. According to Forbes, her net worth is $2.8 billion. She has certainly built up a lot of goodwill among Democrats by backing Barack Obama in 2008 and Hillary Clinton in 2016. She also has contributed more than $95,000 to Democratic candidates and political parties. And of course, she's Oprah. Pretty much all of America knows her thanks to her decades of appearing on television and acting in movies. But what about the weaknesses? Everyone has them. There are others who have spent their careers fighting for the same things Oprah presumably would. And they can appeal to the same elements of the Democratic base to win public office. Even the most popular candidate needs to get their message to the voters, identify supporters, bring them to the polls. Experienced politicians know how to build such an organization. Oprah has none of that right now. Her business ties are extensive and include a cable channel and magazine. She's also a contributor to CBS News' 60 Minutes, and that could pose conflicts of interest if she decides to run. But the opportunity is immense. When a reality television star and billionaire real estate developer with no previous political or military experience can be elected president, why not Oprah Winfrey? Donald Trump's approval ratings have fallen to 37% since the release of Fire and Fury, that controversial book on the Trump administration. And there's a threat too. Would the Oprah aura be able to protect her from the slings and arrows of a modern political campaign? A day after her Golden Globe speech, pictures have emerged of her with disgraced Hollywood mogul Harvey Weinstein. So while she may have spent most of her life on a television screen, presidential candidates face a vetting far more invasive than anything she has ever endured.